So I first received a rescue message from a sister of my friends early this January. From there, I started to gather the information like the location and the situation, the working situation over there. We gathered the information and submit to the local authorities as well as the police department for the rescue. From all the Malaysian being rescued, I was told, but actually forced to scam the people instead of working as a hotel receptionist. They are forced to work to create a fake social account to scam the people on the social media.
I'm Ah Heng. I'm 19 years old. I'm from the Kuala Lumpur. On 2月18日, 在网上的聘请骗到柬埔寨的里面帮诈骗集团做事。 就第一天做一个包装出来嘛， 这个是女生聊男生， 要去Instagram那边找女孩子的照片， 再把它包装成白富美， 都是找有那些韩服的衣服就行了嘛， 把这个女孩子 在小时候读了大学之后，哈佛大学，我觉得长相是不重要啊，因为我们最主要是跟客户聊得开心，就觉得他的照片有那种打高尔夫球啊、打网球的就已经够了。如果我要这个客户相信我，我一定要给他知道我为什么会在这个平台可以赚那么多钱，我才可以带他赚钱啊，让客户给多一点信任感啊。 我在Facebook或者在交友软件里面，就找到你这个男生，我就去跟你聊天，就前面最基本的都是介绍嘛，介绍完了过后，我们就再继续聊生感情，聊生感情过后再到好像男女朋友的关系，如果可以当到男女朋友的关系呢，就是证明他对你的信任感至少都有一点了，到时候就问他有没有兴趣。
投资啊之类的，说这个还是Bitcoin啊，它就有个平台，你就可以钓到它的哦。Most of them are targeting Southeast Asia country, including Singapore and Malaysia. They will be given a KPI to target 15 people a day. If let's say they fail to achieve the target, they'll be punished or being tortured.
我被电是被电过一次，但是被打的话应该是有几十次啊。第一次被打的时候，我就感觉，毕竟我在家也是一个独生子嘛，就连我家人也不舍得打我，你们给什么就会让一个外人来打我，但是我也没有办法反抗，工作环境也是很，就好像就所谓他们说的卖猪仔的猪的厂，就是很肮脏，而且如果你说那感受的话就。 就天天起来，你都是要想想着怎么要去跟客户聊。如果你没找到客户，你惩罚，这个就是一种很大的压力。那个时候我就想离开，却离开不了，因为楼下真的是太多保安了，而且你从三楼跳下也是会很危险，所以到了19日我才把这个真相告诉我的家人。
I was told that they actually find that Malaysian and Singaporeans are easy to be scammed, especially elderlies. When they disguise their account with a beautiful profile, most of the elderlies will be attracted to it, and then they're willing to deposit so-called money or savings to that fake account, which was given by the scammers. The fund they receive or scam actually ranging between $10,000 to $100,000.
So this is not the first time for the embassy to deal with this issue. We have been dealing this issue since 2019. We have above around 50 to 60 Malaysian that we have rescued so far. Normally, is the operation is done quietly. The reason why they are considered very successful is because they use your own nationals to trick you. That is why when Malaysians were caught into this online scamming, according to the report, they were asked or they were forced then to scam other Malaysians. I think you speak the same language, you speak the same dialect, you trust more on your nationals. So that is why it is important for us to inform, it's important for us to also to advise and keep our Malaysians or any national to be aware of this. That this indicates these are not amateurs. They are quite good. They are professionals.
I just want the whole world to not be for a high commission 的一个贴纸而去被骗过去。